Panargatta Zoo officials say they need at least 2 crore rupees every month to run its operations. Most of its revenue comes from visitors and donations. The zoo used up its entire savings in lockdown and tried various cost-cutting measures. They cut down on fodder expenses by using grass from their own land, but it is not enough.
So during COVID time, we did request to government to provide a support for several other activities. And we haven't received it, but then we could manage.
Zoo Authority of Karnataka has asked government to provide 0.5% of CSR funds. CSR consulting agencies that recommend companies say the cause is not a priority area yet.
As of now, we work on like education and health initiatives. So I'm not sure about any like on the animal adoption.
Currently, the zoo has over 2,000 animals, out of which 211 have been adopted in last 1 year. Through this, the zoo raised only 25 lakhs. Wildlife experts say zoo animals are used to this environment and need human protection.
The zoo's animals need more welfare compared to the other wild animals, because the zoo's animals cannot be released back to wild once they are captivated.
Though the footfall in the zoo is almost back to pre-COVID levels, officials fear that the second wave of COVID-19 can be harmful. This is reporter Puran Chaudhary for CityCast.